Since the dawn of time, folks have been afraid of those who can command dark forces. Few figures have been famous enough to color an entire era, but witches have done just that over and over again. Whether the fear they inspired was deserved or just a result of people looking for outsiders to ostracize, the legend remains. However, when a witch summons a demon, all bets are off because that gets wild. So of course there are plenty of movies about just such an event. Scary movies with scary witches. With that in mind, we're gonna jump into today's list, the top 5 scary witches who summoned a demon. Coming in number 5, we've got Mother Suspiriorum. Thankfully, this witch mostly minds her own business. It's always good to have a demon summoning witch stay in her lane. It shows maturity and purpose, and most of all, an unwillingness to get innocent and unrelated parties involved. Mother Suspiriorum is mostly concerned with the smooth running of the Helena Marcos Dance Academy, and as such, will do all sorts of heinous things to ensure everything goes well. These acts don't really reach out beyond the immediate interests and connections at the academy, though. Still, her spellcast and demonic involvements are terrifying to say the least. Throughout Suspiria, we see all sorts of spells cast by the matronly witches. A poor student who had caught on to the magical nature of the academy is brought to a secret room and has her body unknowingly contorted by Mother Suspiriorum's vessel, Susie Banyan. This horrible twisting and turning performance renders her body a mangled mess, but isn't quite a demonic summon. Then we see a girl dropped through the floor, which results in a broken leg. Still, the witchcraft inherent in the academy puts her into a trance and has her complete a performance upon that snapped limb. Ouch. The true demonic summoning occurs when Helena Marcos herself attempts to take full control of the school. In a ritual meant to transfer her into Susie, it's revealed that Susie is indeed Mother Suspiriorum, one of the 3 founding witches. This is where the scary stuff becomes very apparent. Interrupting Marcos' ritual, Suspiriorum declares that Marcos is a false leader and all of her followers must be punished. To do so, she summons an incarnation of death and lets it run wild. And run wild it does. This blood-soaked abomination tears through the followers of the false prophet, rending their flesh and melting them down to nothing. Those who were not on Marcos's side can do nothing but look on in terror as their contemporaries are torn apart by an otherworldly presence. But hey, at least they get to survive. With this death-filled ritual complete, Suspiriorum is free to roam about in Susie's body, watching over those who were involved with the academy. However, it seems she's not too eager to summon another demon right away. Another ritual someday, perhaps. Coming in number 4, we've got Haggis from Pumpkinhead. Now here's a movie with a totally different vibe for you. No dancing, no intrigue, but definitely a bloody demon looking to kill some youths. She may not have an academy to inherit, but Haggis is definitely good at casting spells and summoning demons. This witch looks more like a witch than pretty much anybody on this list, too. Gnarled features, wispy hair, living a hermit's life far away from anyone and everyone. The whole 9 witchy yards. The thing Haggis is most well known for is definitely the summoning of Pumpkinhead, though. All of the potions, brews, hexes, and curses in the world wouldn't amount to half the suffering this demon causes. She doesn't really even want to do it either, but Ed Harley, a grieving widower who recently also lost his son in a freak accident, refuses to walk away with nothing. At first, he requests that Haggis bring his son back to life. This, unfortunately, is not within her power. However, she can offer up something else. Revenge. Ed jumps at the opportunity, not exactly knowing what he's in for. In doing so, he dooms all sorts of people, including himself. Knowing what's in store, Haggis warns Ed of the terrible price he'll pay, but goes through with the ritual regardless. Unearthing a corpse from the mountain graveyard, Ed offers up both his and his son's blood to Haggis to summon Pumpkinhead. This demonic creature rises from the earth and begins a terrifying killing spree. It makes its way to the teens responsible for the death of Ed's son and methodically ends their lives. Ed starts to see these gruesome murders through the eyes of the demon and realizes the mistake he's made. Too late though. Pumpkinhead cannot be stopped until its revenge mission is complete. Haggis warns Ed that if he tries to stop Pumpkinhead, he'll die too. This results in Ed discovering that he and the demon are inextricably linked. Any damage done to Ed happens to the demon too. With this information, Ed decides to lay his own life on the line to end the madness, and successfully kills both himself and the demon. Haggis then collects their bodies and returns them to the mountain. Someday though, she'll bring the demon back. Someday. Coming in number three, we've got the Borrower Witch from Supernatural. There are plenty of demons and witches to choose from in this famous series, but the Borrower Witch seems to fit this list the best. This witch in particular, interestingly enough, has no real name. She's known almost exclusively by her title. To gain her supernatural powers, this woman made a deal with the demon. For her soul, she received a demonic signet ring which provided her with great power. She was able to cast many spells, and her life was extended far beyond the limits of an average individual. However, as her life started to wane, she decided it was time to pass on her gift. This wasn't a pleasant mentorship opportunity, though. She decided that she was going to go on a killing spree to attract another promising young witch. Oh, and so she did. During her killing spree, Tasha Baines tracked her down and refused to be her subordinate. Because of this, the Borrower Witch killed Tasha, which kicked off a whole new series of events involving cutting hearts out of chests, twig and twine dolls, and witch-killing bullets. Damn. Coming in number two, we've got Sarah from the Neon Demon. This could be a very wild reading of this movie, but I think it works out just fine. The Neon Demon is the tale of a young orphaned model named Jessie who moves to LA in an attempt to make it big. At first, she's innocent and afraid, unsure of herself and looking to others for help. Enter Sarah, one of the three big presences in the movie. She appears alongside Gigi, another model, and immediately takes interest in Jessie. Sarah and Gigi are shunned by many powerful figures in the modeling community following the arrival of Jessie. This makes them jealous and angry. Sarah speaks with Jessie about how easy it must be for her because everyone loves and admires her. This is the inciting incident in Jessie's coming ritual. As narcissism takes over, Sarah watches from afar. Jessie shoots to the top quickly, for sure, but in doing so, loses some previous parts of herself. And she starts seeing strange neon symbols all over the place in her life. Her dreams begin to showcase horrifying and possibly demonic imagery. While her professional life soars, the people around her begin to disappear or expect more from her. This culminates in Jessie being killed and eaten by Sarah, Gigi, and makeup artist Ruby. Okay. I see this as Sarah being a witch of sorts, looking for the flesh and blood of a younger, more desirable person to use as a potion of youth. She summons the titular demon to slowly eat away at Jessie's life until nothing but that beauty is left, and then consumes her in that concentrated state. Gigi can't handle the meal, but Sarah is ready to roll with this fountain of youth. She found her ticket and used some magical, demonic means to claim it. Or maybe I'm reading too far into it. Who knows? And finally, at number one, we've got Thomasin from The Witch. You might be thinking, isn't Thomasin the least scary witch in this movie? We see a seductive figure morph into a gnarled old crone who makes a young man vomit an entire apple and then eventually kills him. A baby is stolen and processed into flying ointment. How is the puritanical Thomasin, who decides to only join the coven at the very end of the movie, the scariest witch? Well, that's the thing. She was devout throughout the flick, asking for forgiveness from God, staying with her family even when accused of sin and treachery by her mother, the works. But even with all of that, she was unable to protect her family and ended up totally alone. Desperation takes over and she summons the devil himself through Black Phillip, the demon who tempted and methodically killed her entire family in myriad gruesome ways. She decides that she will give her soul to him forever to avoid dying in the wilderness. So while Thomasin herself might not be a scary witch, the things she had to go through only to end up making a deal with the devil are very scary. What a flick. Damn, I can't wait for Halloween. All this talk of witches and witchy movies has me all riled up. Demons too, of course. So what'd you think of the list? Do you agree with my picks? What is the scariest demon a witch has ever summoned? Can you conjure up any real life stories? Make sure you let me know down in the comments. Speaking of comments, let's take a look at some of your more pernicious ones from the top 5 most haunted items at the Warren Occult Museum. Matthew Schodel says, well, nice to know you got us all possessed by showing us a picture of the doll. You knew the risks when you started looking for scary videos online. You could have stuck on the not scary side of the internet. Hmm? India Smith says, stop dumpster diving, everyone. You can bring cursed items into your home and they can make your life a living hell. Curses are very real and so are demons, which are very hard to get rid of. But who's just throwing away cursed items in the dumpster, though? Lamia's Diary says, I wouldn't even want to be in the same room as these totems. You and most people. Jasper Leichty says, you should do some of the items in Zach Bagans' museum. I mean, Ed Gein's cauldron? Creepy. Ask and you shall receive, although I personally did not participate in that video. And DeWaxFacts says, little fun fact, somebody opened Annabelle's box, how I know her hands are in different positions, or maybe it moved on its own. Both possibilities are less than ideal, eh? And that is all the time we have for today. I am going to eat a cursed finger and figure it out from there. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Few figures have been famous enough. Wow, I wrote that wrong. The true demonic summoning occurs when Helena Marcos attempts. The true demonic summoning occurs. Whoop. This witch looks. She doesn't even want to do it, really. No, she doesn't really even want to do it. She doesn't. It makes its way to the teens responsible for the death of a series of events, including.